So how many of you guys follow soccer, even if it's just very casually? Say, maybe you only pay attention every 4 years when the U.S. is in the World Cup. It's about what I expected. It's not very popular here. But Matt, you're one of the people that raised your hand, so let me ask you a follow-up. Who do you think is the best soccer player in the world right now?
Lionel Messi.
That's what I figured you might say. And for those of you who don't know, who that is, he's an Argentinian soccer player, and he's during his career, he's won just about every award in the book. So many people, like Matt, say he's the best in the game. But that's not what I'm here to talk about. In fact, I'm here to convince you otherwise. You see, in reality, based on his dynamic skill set, his incredible work ethic, and his worldwide success, the best player in the world is none other than Cristiano Ronaldo. Now see, I was lucky enough 2 years ago when on vacation with my family to get some tickets and actually see him play live in Spain. And that's what really cemented this for me, this position that I have of him being the best in the world. And I don't expect you guys to go out and do that. It's quite the ordeal. Hard to find tickets. But what I do want you to do is just, all you have to do is sit on your couch, turn on your TV this weekend, flip over to ESPN, and see the highlight reel display that he's sure to put on. Alright, so the first thing I want to do is just give you guys a brief career history so you can see how Ronaldo progressed and became where he is today. So, according to ESPNsoccer.com, he started his career at age 15 when he signed his first professional deal with the B-League side Nacional in Portugal. And that year he led him to a title, which caused him to be snapped up by a bigger club, Sporting Lisbon, which is Portugal's most historic and successful soccer team. He was there for 2 years. Once again, even though he was such a young player, he was good enough to lead them to a title, and that's where his career took a bit of a turn. After leading his current team, Sporting Lisbon, to a victory over Manchester United, 3-1, he scored 2 goals in the process, and the opposing manager was so impressed with his skills that the next year he bought him, according to transfermarket.com, for a fee of £12.2 million, which is quite a lot of money to spend on someone who's only 18 years old at the time. England is where he really flourished. He developed his career, and he scored his first goal for Man United on November 1st, 2003. A little video here shows you guys.
It is Ronaldo, and it's in!
As you guys can see, that's pretty impressive stuff for someone who's like only as old or even younger than some of the people in this room. Now, all in all, he spent 6 seasons in England, and he scored 118 goals in that time, and he also captained his team to 3 more league titles, so continuing his run of success. Then in 2009, fairly recently, he took the next step in his career and joined Spanish super team Real Madrid, where he currently plays. To date, he's played 175 games for them, and scored 275 goals in that time, which is the best rate for any player in that amount of games in soccer history. He also recently captained them to the Champions League title, and the Champions League is the most prestigious tournament in all of soccer, save the World Cup, I guess. And so now that you guys know a little bit about his history and where he came from, I can tell you guys what sets him apart and truly makes him the best player in the world. As I mentioned before, he's the most well-rounded soccer player to, I think, ever play the game. You see, most soccer players, like Lionel Messi, prefer one foot over the other. They'll only use that one. For example, Messi, out of his 400 or something goals, he's only scored 47 with his weaker foot, whereas Ronaldo, with his weak foot, has scored 98. And so clearly, he's adept at using both feet, which makes him very hard to defend against, and just he's a great attacker because of that. Another thing he's very good at is using his head to score goals. Now, I mean, part of that might be genetically, considering that he's 6'3" and built like a house, so it's not really hard for him to get up there and head the ball into the net. But in his career so far, because it's far from over, he scored 55 goals with his head, which is more than double the average for any player over a 10-year career. Not only is he obviously very talented, but he's also one of the hardest-working athletes in any sport on the entire planet, up there with the likes of Kobe or LeBron James. An article in the Daily Mail said that his teammates in Madrid would say that he's always the first to show up for training. He's been warming up for 30, 45 minutes by the time the rest of them get there, and he's always there at least an hour or even two by the time they're done. Some of the training staff even leave the building before he's out. He's also very committed to keeping himself in almost ridiculous physical shape. According to SoccerNet.com, he says he does 1,000 crunches and 300 push-ups every single day to keep himself in shape, which may seem kind of ridiculous to you guys, but for anyone that watched the World Cup and saw him tear his shirt off, it's pretty believable, because he's just a freak of a human being. Not only that, but his two-footedness isn't something he was born with, it's actually something that he had to learn. When he was at Manchester United, he realized that he was very weak with his left foot, and so he trained himself to be better with it, to the point where he can use either one with basically the same result. Lastly, he's had great successes in leagues all across the world. As you guys may have noticed when I was talking about his career history, every single team he's played on from the beginning of his career has won a title while he's there, often because he was there and because he's so good and such a great leader. Since the time he's been in the Spanish league, which is where he currently is, he's done just as well, if not better, than Lionel Messi in that amount of time, scoring 45 goals a season, according to Bleacher Report, compared to Messi's 32. And then not only that, but he was able to succeed greatly in England, winning 3 titles, like I said. And that's important because that's considered by most people to be the toughest league in the world, the most physical, and the hardest to succeed in. So the fact that he's able to do well around the world speaks volumes about what great a player he is. In conclusion, although the debate on who the greatest in the world is an interesting and often a very controversial one, I think I've made it very clear why Cristiano Ronaldo is the best soccer player on the planet. His diversity and his skill set allows him to attack the field in a multitude of ways and makes him an absolute nightmare to defend. And beyond that, he's a hardworking athlete who's had to work for everything he's got rather than being gifted with natural talent, and he's managed to become a worldwide success. So, like I said, guys, I don't want you to just take my word for it, take what I have to say at face value. I don't expect that you'll go to Spain and watch him play for yourself, but all you have to do is to sit on your couch, flick to SportsCenter, and watch him make magic on the soccer field. Thank you, guys.
Guys, let me hear it.
That was probably the best speech you've given.
Yeah?
Tell him why.
I would not agree.
Because you didn't, even though you were behind the computer, you didn't just hide there. Like, even though you used the computer, came back out to the audience, you really knew what you were talking about, too.
Alright.
Very detailed.
Okay.
I thought you were more, you were calmer, too. Your last speech, you knew everything, but you, tried to get it all out. And I felt with this one, it was more of a speech. You, told us what we needed to know, but you didn't, bombard us with information.